It all started in mid-September when stresses sprung up in the repo market. This is the place banks and financial institutions go to borrow money from each other, often on an overnight basis. Suddenly, there were more borrowers than lenders. Cash flow tightened, interest rates spiked. The Fed was forced to step in, injecting billions of dollars to calm the market.
The problem is that since mid-September, the problem has been growing and growing. We're north of $220 billion now that the Fed has been supplying to the repo market to keep it very, very calm.
It's still unclear why cash got tighter. Some point to the Fed's attempts to shrink its own balance sheet, while others blame post-crisis banking regulations, which require lenders to keep more cash in reserve. For now, though, there's little evidence the volatility is foreshadowing an impending crisis, the way a sudden tightening in the repo market did in 2007.
What it does foreshadow, though, is the Treasury market has changed. The government is selling lots of debt because it's running such big budget deficits. Foreign buyers like the Chinese aren't buying quite so much. And today we are having some frictions that if we don't solve, we could have repeated episodes like this.
The Fed has been trying to separate what's happening in the repo market from monetary policy. When it announced that it was going to start growing its balance sheet again earlier this month through the purchase of Treasury bills, it insisted it wasn't another round of quantitative easing, which led to some confusion.
I suppose they're kind of related, but I think they're trying very hard to say, we are trying to fix the plumbing issue without changing monetary policy.
That may be the intention, but some experts are skeptical that the Fed's intervention in the repo market won't be a substitute for future easing.
The Fed can make an announcement if they want to and now announce that they're going to cut rates. That's easy to understand. Or they could keep buying bills and Treasury and 3-month Treasury bill rates, which repo and short-term funding and adjustable rate mortgages are all tied to. Those rates can keep falling because the Fed is buying. That is a rate cut. They could pretend it's not, but it is.
Meaning that easing could continue even if the Fed signals an end to this latest round of rate cuts. Toni Waterman, CGTN, Washington.